Warning, during this video, there will be irritating high-pitched sound notes. It is highly recommended to unplug your earphones while watching it.
Hello guys, I hope you all are safe and sound during this pandemic situation. In our recent times, we have started making use of IoT, or you can say Internet of Things. So basically, in one of our last video, we made a weather station, which was amazing project, which was great. We have mounted it on our balcony. If you haven't watched that video, you can find a link to it in the description or maybe in the card section. So today in this video, we will make a motion activated alarm system for a home or garage. We will learn how this motion activation sensor works, how to wire it, how to code it, and how to make an Android / iOS app. Yes, iOS, because you guys love iOS, right? So yeah, we will bring this entire project into vision. So let's get started.
Let's discuss the problem statement of this project. We basically need a system that can be activated on motion. Later on, we will generate a very high pitch irritating sound as alarm, and finally we will add ability to switch the alarm on / off and get notified on app whenever an alarm is triggered. Since all the chips are on table, we will discuss each components, starting with motion sensor. There are obviously many choices for motion detection, like camera, PIR sensor, RF based sensor, and few industrial options which after all use PIR in different footprints. But the cheapest option is RCWL0516 module, or say RCWL516, which is based on EM wave at microwave frequencies. But don't get scared with the microwave term, since the power rating of this module is in milliwatts. Let's have a closer look at this sensor so that we can get a basic idea of working. The RCWL0516 works on Doppler effect. Well, what is Doppler effect, you might ask? Let's hear it from Sheldon.
It's the apparent change in the frequency of a wave caused by relative motion between the source of the wave and the observer.
The module itself is an engineering marvel. It is divided in two basic parts. One is the control / mixer part, which is based on IC RCWL9196. And few complementary passive components that make up Colpritt's oscillator. The other part is antenna, microwave inductor, and microwave capacitor, which is built right on the PCB. This module basically sends an EM wave, and whenever there is a motion due to Doppler effect, this EM wave either gets compressed or decompressed, which is observed by shift in frequency. In either case, the mixer will sense difference and indicate an output for 2 seconds. This output time could be increased by adding additional capacitor on SMD pad attached on the back side of PCB. This sensor is rated for 7 meter usage. By soldering 1 mega ohm resistor on RGN pad, we can easily reduce the sensitivity to 5 meters somewhat. I have plans to use it along with a microcontroller, so it is unnecessary to add capacitors for trigger time, since it can be done using code. Talking about microcontroller, we need an IoT node so that we can easily control or receive data whenever there is an intrusion. My go-to choice for IoT node is NodeMCU, or say ESP8266, which is very simple to use and can be coded using Arduino IDE. For buzzer or alarm system, I use this industrial alarm, which is generally used in ATMs or other industrial applications. An electronic hooter could be a great option, but it is a little expensive and overkill for household applications. So, this alarm fits quite the task. It works on 230 volt AC and has a knob to adjust the pitch. We will set the pitch to maximum irritation level for maximum efficiency. Also, we will add a single channel relay to control our 230 volt buzzer using our NodeMCU. For software or app part, we need a notification on either phone or maybe via email, for which we can use Blink, since it reduces quite of our work. We will also add a software button to basically switch the system on or off while not in use. I initially wanted to add a software kill switch, but in case of no internet, it would simply fail. So I didn't waste my time in adding interrupt and kept the code very simple. Talking about the code, we have added Blink library along with ESP8266 Wi-Fi library. Next, we defined our Wi-Fi SSID, Wi-Fi password and authentication code from Blink app, which I will show you in a minute. In the setup section, we declared the required input-output parameters. At last, we declared a loop which starts with a condition to check the RCWL output. Once the RCWL output and the output of the app switch is active, we will strobe two patterns of sound and alert it. We will also send an email and app notification along with the wonderful tweet. Now let's open our phone and install Blink app via App Store or Play Store. Next, register to Blink Network and create a new project. Give any name to your project, then select the device as Node MCU and connection mode as Wi-Fi. Once the project is created, we will receive an email with authentication code that needs to be added in the following lines of code. Once that is done, upload the code on Node MCU and we will continue our app building part by adding widgets to our dashboard. Swipe right on dashboard and click on button widget, which will add it to the dashboard. Next, tap on that button to open its properties. On output, select digital pin D4 and leave the rest of the options as standard or untouched. Again, swipe right and add notification, email and Twitter widgets. Once it is done, simply click on run. After that, our app part and software part is basically done. Let's talk about connections now. The RCWL0516 module has 5 pins, out of which we will use only 3 pins, that is VIN, ground and output. Connect the VIN to 3.3 volt of Node MCU, ground pin to ground pin and output to digital pin D0 of Node MCU. Connect relay signal pin to digital pin D6 of Node MCU. We will power everything using a 5 volt power supply whose circuit I removed and soldered the plus 5 volt to VIN of Node MCU and ground to ground. At this point, let me warn you, we are working with 230 volt AC. I am being careful is an understatement. You can find proper connection diagram and links to purchase parts in my blog article of Minov Blogs, which is linked in the description below. Once everything is done, we can test this system. I turned on the system and went to another room, and when I re-entered, see how accurately this system got triggered and pattern of alarm is observed. It is quite irritating, which is the goal of our project. By this time, our project and circuit is almost done, but like always, I don't like to see my circuit as a mess. So I will enclose it inside an electrical box. Just remember one important thing. We are working with 230 volt AC, so it's a good idea to isolate the board using electrical tape or maybe hot glue. I would like to point the sensor at an angle and little bit away from the power supply circuit to avoid interference and get maximum efficiency. Once everything is in place, we can conclude this project. I must say, this might not be the perfect solution. Few other commercial options might be better for home security and maybe more trustworthy, but as an engineer, this project was a learning curve and definitely works if you know what you're doing. I hope you guys learned something from this project and this video, and if you did, give this video a like, share it with your friends. Also, consider subscribing to our channel, it's completely free. I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.